Let's look at some of my stock cocks. It's January 10th, 2024. It's our winter here, getting ready to pair. As you can see, the health and condition of these pigeons. This is a three-section loft. I just put down these wood pellets, Tractor Supply. They're just used for burning in the wood stove. My pigeons have never seen a drop of antibiotics in their lifetime. You can notice the health and the condition of these pigeons. And I've been 10 years antibiotic free. I worm them, I vaccinate them, I give them great care. The main reason for this video is for you to see my breeding loft. It's three sections, one of my breeding lofts. These are big nests. I'll put some fronts on them when I go to pair the birds. The wood pellets are on the floor. I want you to see the condition of the pigeons. These are pigeons that have never been medicated in their entire life. It is raining today. It's kind of a nasty day, but it's not cold. That blue cock in the center, that's RISB number 71. Superstar breeder, generations of champions from him. The cock up there on the top. Another superstar, retired racer. He below him was actually a retired racer, now behind all kinds of winners. He's, you know, jocked Jost Juicen bloodlines with some of my old Venus pigeons from Belgium. And again, you can see some of these cocks. And again, health, condition, it can be done. That cock in the center that's walking in, Hall of Fame pigeon, long distance superstar. He's DeRosa Blonde with some Twin Bongers pigeon. Again, down for my old Venus cock, this pigeon right here. One of my favorites is Checker. He is a DeRosa Blonde cock. He was second in a big maturity race. I retired him. He's been a terrific breeder. The blue Checker in the center. But the main reason of this video is to just see what it looks like. Pigeons that have been on natural health their entire life. Another retired cock, half DeRosa Blonde, retired racer. It's fun breeding some pigeons that were super successful on the race team. The pigeon right here, big Waddle. It's a son of the old Dark Hen, one of my best breeding hens. He's a really top breeding cock. He's a 2016 bird. His brother bred the first Hoosier winner. Looks like they don't really care for the camera. This cock right here, this blue, that is a inbred half-brother to Shakira, the famous hen of the Best Kittle family. I'll be mating this cock that's looking into the camera to my daughter of Best Kittle when he was mated to Shakira. She's in quarantine right now. Beautiful blue cock, but again, notice the health, notice the wattles, notice the condition of these pigeons. These pigeons have never seen a drop of antibiotics in their entire lives. I vaccinate them, I worm them, and I give them the minerals that they need, and the condition is there. The blue cock in the center, that's RISB 71, superstar racer. I retired him as a two-year-old. He's behind all kinds of champions. I mean, amazing. AU convention winners, one-off winners. The Dark Checker in the back corner, if you can see him, he won the 2018 Hoosier Classic Million Dollar Race. That Dark Cock, beautiful pigeon. He is a grandson of the famous Dark Hen, the old hen that I have here. But again, mainly wanting you to see the condition of the pigeons going into breeding season. Another terrific breeding cock. I picked him out in Blackpool when I was at the show several years ago. His father bred all kinds of winners against thousands and thousands of pigeons. And he's been a top breeder here. That is a bird bred by Ad Shalikins. He's a grandfather to top birds. Up here we have a double inbred grandson of Den Ad. He's an import. He's been a good cock. Not a big fan of the color, but he's bred Hoosier Classic Prize winners 2 years in a row. He's a grandfather to winners. This cock, I don't have much in the Kittle bloodline. He's bred from a full sister to the mother of Kittle. Something to play with. Beautiful pigeon. These are some big nests here. I will do some selective pairing, only because there's certain hens I don't want to mate to the same cock as they were mated to last year. So I'll switch them and get them mated and change the pairings. Most of my matings will be free mating. The birds usually do a better job than we do at selecting their own mates. So they'll get to pick their own mates, which has worked really well. Then at the end of the season, I can pair some special pairings in individual breeding pens. But that's mainly for sale. The birds that race tend to be bred in a group. Birds are much happier in a group environment. They're a community animal and they breed better babies and they're just more content. There's my best son of the freak there on the feeder. Beautiful blue cock behind many winners. He's a 2016 bird. But again, I just wanted to highlight the health and the condition of the pigeons. And it's very easy. It's just easy to keep this kind of health and the condition because I only breed from pigeons and keep pigeons that stay naturally healthy. And I have this kind of health and condition. This cock, the blue cock to the left, that's the inbred half-brother to Shakira. And there's the best son of the freak right there, standing on the feeder. As you can see, this is what I use for loft dressing on the floor. I buy it at Tractor Supply, the premium grade fuel pellets, just hard wood pellets made for pellet stoves for heating your home. Don't buy the animal grade ones, they're too soft, the quality isn't the same. Buy the ones made for wood stoves, you'll be pleased. The lighting isn't the best in this middle section here. That's my best breeding Casbor cock right there, the blue white flight. Another Casbor cock, the splash. She's kind of a new one. Again, it's a three-section breeding loft. I will be taking some of these cocks out of the loft. I'm not going to breed them all. And the wood pellets are down. There's the Hoosier winner right there, the dark checker. And I'll show you the bag of these wood pellets, what I do, and where I buy them. Great, great loft bedding. Super. Keeps it nice and dry. So look at some of the breeding cocks. I have another breeding loft that I use. And again, I'm going to pull out some of these pigeons and not breed from them all this year. I'll show you what I feed them. There's chicken pellets from Tractor Supply on that side, and that's Tractor Supply deer corn on that side. I'll feed this until, you know, the eggs hatch, and then I'll move to a Vercella Laga Champion. I usually mix NNG in with that, or mostly Vercella Laga Champion. All the minerals they can want, plus I'll have a feeder of chicken pellets at all times in front of the breeders. They don't eat much of the chicken pellets, but they do provide a nice amount of protein and minerals. We'll see who's out front here. Some of the cocks. Mainly just seeing the health and the condition, winter day, rainy day, of pigeons that have never seen a drop of medication in their entire lifetimes. This is Frank McLaughlin, McLaughlin Loft. If you put some comments down below, if you want me to highlight a pigeon or a family, let me know. And hope you enjoy my videos and you subscribe and tell your friends.